In order to build democratic, pluralistic societies, a group of women leaders and activists from the Middle East, Africa, and Asia came together to develop an alternative model for leadership, one that is based on consensus building, effective communication, and horizontal participation. Leading to choices is a result of that collaboration. This handbook is a learning tool and primer on developing leadership styles that promote gender equality and democratic processes.
The kind of leadership we're talking about is built on respect for the individual as an individual and a belief in the fact that everyone has something important to say to each issue that people are involved with.
I think this horizontal leadership is important because otherwise you're preaching.
Where everybody feels a sense of ownership and belonging to the idea.
It's more of collective actions and collective vision.
Leadership qualities are in everybody. What we need is to give them the place, the time, and they will be able to bring the best of themselves.
Trainers from the Women's Learning Partnership's partner organizations gather together at WLP's pilot Roaming Institute for Training of Trainers. They met to develop strategies for promoting participatory learning and workshops for women's leadership. This video showcases some facilitation techniques for creating learning environments that are engaging, inclusive, and democratic. In this video, trainers simulate a variety of facilitation techniques: energizers to jumpstart workshops, icebreakers to increase group participation, large and small group activities to stimulate discussion and promote collaboration, and evaluation sessions to encourage self-critiques. Our goal is to share strategies for making horizontal leading an effective means of promoting women's empowerment. Energizers are a helpful way of starting workshops and getting participants to become comfortable talking in a group. We began this workshop with an energizer we like to call Draw Your Animal Self.
Look at her gorilla.
This is my gorilla.
It looks more like a Buddha.
You drink bird?
Bird or a chicken?
A chicken. Is it a chicken?
I love cats, and I wish I could be like a cat. You know, because they're so independent, they do whatever they want, they're so languid, you know, everything is on their own terms, you know, they want you, they go to you, they don't want you, they go away, you know, and I wish I can be like that.
Yes?
Well, as Gushto, Pusto, Pashmo, Shirish Ham, Estfala Misha.
I have picked a lamb because it's a very peaceful animal. It never fights, and the milk and the skin, and what else? Meat. The milk and the skin is always useful to society.
Ça me rappelle une chanson de mon enfance qui disait: Réouvrez la cage aux oiseaux. Regardez les s'envoler, c'est beau. Les enfants, si vous voyez les petits oiseaux prisonniers, ouvrez-leur la porte vers la liberté.
You share that? Okay. Oh, that's why Allah man. Thank you.
I suggest is that we started by a session of imagination.
Icebreakers are another way to stimulate conversation. This workshop began with a role-playing exercise on ways to increase women's political participation.
To try to each of us feel that she is one of the Jordanian women in southern Jordan. See herself a woman there, and she can choose the her profession, her age, her family situation, whatever, and give herself a different character. Mm-hmm. Do you accept this suggestion?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Okay. Can we start with the characters?
I'm Amna. I'm 45 years old, housewife. I have 5 girls, 2 sons. I'm suffering from my husband. He is very dominant. I've heard about your workshop from my neighbor. I began to afraid the future of my daughters. I don't want them to have the life that I had. So I want to learn something to lead them how to have better future.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
My name is Bahar. I am 35 years. I am economist, and I work in the business structure.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes.
I am Saudi. I am 60 years old. I'm here because you did not invite my association, and I want to know why.
Uh-huh. Okay. Okay. Yes.
I'm
Lamia.
Lamia. Okay. I'm Lamia and
Zahra.
Okay. Zahra dragged me to this workshop. Uh-huh. I'm really not interested. But because, you know, she cannot, it's hard for her to go out alone, and she asked me to accompany her. So I'm here because she wanted me.
And
so
we gossip on the way.
Yeah.
Okay.
To create a truly participatory environment, it's important for each participant to articulate her goals so the workshop may be adapted to meet her expectations. This is a simulation of a workshop on developing a political advocacy campaign in Jordan.
But then now we need, because some of the participants, as you noticed, was talking about their expectations, what they are looking for in this workshop. So what is the your first priority of goals that you want to achieve after this, through this workshop? One idea from each participant, and we will start from here.
I hope to be able to convince the women of my association that the vote is power. They should recognize the power of their vote and use it well to vote in women in this incoming election.
Propagate idea of election in the mahallas.
In the?
Mahalla.
Mahalla?
Mahalla, community.
Ah, community, mahalla. Ah, it's in Arabic. Mahalla, it's in the Egyptian way of saying community.
Yeah,
they community. Said mahalla.
Mahalla,
yeah. Okay, then the point is to know and to take the idea. How to take the idea of the need of elections to the community.
I'd like to make sure that the women who get elected through our support will feel indebted so that they will really pay attention to our issues.
Create a safe space where every participant can share her opinions and ideas, like this collective brainstorming session.
So we are here from different backgrounds to think together and to learn from each other what we can do to have better participation of women in the next election and more effective participation as voters and as candidates. So let's think about materials that we need, and each of you can give me one idea about things that we can have in our hands. Yes?
I'd like to know the process of counting the votes. Mm-hmm. That they'll start counting the votes from my village and so on and so forth, so that if there is some fraud, we will know.
Okay, what else?
Women don't have money. So the women that we're working with would want to know, they're very much interested in the next elections, and they would want to know if there are any groups or any information that you have of where they can go to seek for funds, or, you know, if you have any information on how they can also do some fundraising to get funds to run for elections.
Dividing the workshop into smaller teams enables members to engage in deeper conversations. Here, participants formulate campaign strategies for increasing women's involvement in elections.
Work as three groups together, each of them focused on one area. Try to plan for before elections, during the elections, and after the elections. And the three groups will try to meet these expectations.
We have 200,000 citizens, 80,000 voters.
Mm-hmm. How many?
We have one.
We have three seats. For three seats. How many?
Women in business.
Women in business.
There aren't many in business.
We
can contact in the eye. In the eye. In the eye support.
They don't give personal.
No, they can.
They can give money to the campaign.
Contact international NGOs.
We are 40,000 women. We are going for the party candidates who are Muslim and who are women.
Can we try to present?
Reconvening small teams into larger group discussion enables participants to share their strategies with each other and move collectively towards their goals for the workshop.
Our first step would be to encourage people that we think are qualified and good people to actually make themselves candidates, because a lot of times we've noticed in our town women don't stand for office. So we'll try to encourage qualified women to make themselves candidates. We will develop committees that would take on various aspects of the work that we have ahead of us. Then we will identify organizations that are sympathetic with women, women's organizations, teachers associations, and so forth. And we also thought that we would use the internet in order to get our message to a larger women's community and maybe get them to help us fundraise as well. Did I miss anything?
No,
okay. Thank you. Okay, the second group.
هناك لازم أقول.
Yes, please.
Oh, now the finally the day comes, but we are very prepared. We have the monitoring committee, and in every site we have two women and sometimes a man and a woman, because we have to involve men more, especially men who believe in our right. So these people are there to see that the votes are very well placed, and then afterwards they count the votes, they monitor, they observe that everything is, there is no cheating or anything. And our big slogan everywhere, vote for a better tomorrow, for a brighter tomorrow, for justice and change.
Okay. We can use
I'm sure she will win, because afterwards, even if she doesn't win, we're going to send everybody a thank you card.
Okay. Thank you.
Encourage her to be accessible to the community, for example, through weekly visits to her constituency office. Media accessibility, for example, a radio program where she responds to the public's questions once a month. And we even have a name for the program. It's called In the Public Interest. Make use of the internet to provide data, progress reports, and linkage with the community. And finally, provide her with honest evaluation in the form of progress reports issued by us.
Okay, thank you. And also maybe it's necessary to celebrate success directly after elections to show the community that she is strong enough. There is a group of people, grassroots people, who are supporting her, and she's not alone.
Participants should evaluate the entire workshop and the facilitator. Facilitators should also critique their own roles during the workshop.
When you were doing a workshop in action, for the time you became participants of a workshop, of the sort of women's leadership workshop that we are all trying to learn to do, the big question is to think critically of how this went. One wonderful test for yourself as you're trying to share the power is, where was the leader? If you don't know where the leader was, something really good is happening. The leaders are everywhere. Well, is there one place in the room that got to be the power spot?
Right where you are.
The power spot. The power spot should be mobile. It should be wherever. Do you remember, Suhair, why you came there? You got up and you walked all the way across the room.
I felt here is the rear of the room, and nobody would make attention, and that is the place where everybody would be looking.
Right.
I felt that was the power spot.
Someone told me, go up to the front.
Aha.
And I chose to stay there because I wanted to be close to my group, because
right.
you know,
you were representing
there any changes,
your group.
Yeah. But I did notice someone say, go to the front.
So those are sensitivities. Rocky.
I actually have a question for the group. I wondered, because all of you have facilitated this or other kinds of workshops in your own countries, and I want to know, what kinds of alternative techniques have you used in your countries, and what have you found challenging when you have done that? Have you used role plays, or if you've used other kinds of techniques? Suppose you were facilitating this workshop in your own country, what would you have done differently, if anything?
Nous avons vécu ça dans nos ateliers. C'était très intéressant, mais il fallait très bien le gérer pour arrêter au moment où la personne devient très très émotive en parlant de soi, pour dédramatiser. Et pour faire en sorte que ce témoignage soit essentiellement un support pour un apprentissage, pour un partage en commun.
Thank you.
Some of the days we gather everybody for a picnic or a party so that we can share the happiness with them.
مثل خودشان لباس می پوشیم.
We dress like them.
و مطابق اما حالتشان صحبت میکنیم صحبت بسیار عادی و عامیانه.
We speak with them in their terminologies, in their colloquial language level.
اول قصه هایی که مورد دلچسپی تعداد زیادتر باشه از خود برشان قصه میکنیم.
First we tell them stories about ourselves that is of more interest to them, that they could relate to.
بعد قصه های خودشان هم شنویم.
Then we listen to their side of the story or their stories.
بعد اهداف خود که حقوقی است یا لیدرشپ است اهداف خود برشان میگیم.
Then we tell them our reasons and for leadership and initiatives.
Depending on the group, some groups would want you to take the lead, but a lot of times what we do, not just in this workshop, you know, the handbook, but also in other trainings that we do, is to make them understand that, look, we're also here to learn. To learn from you. That makes them more, you know, comfortable, at ease, and they open up. So I think that's very important to.
We ask participants to volunteer, you know.
Do things.
And so sometimes the facilitator will come from the participants.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And so we just, and we fade into the background and allow them the space to make the decisions and so on.
If we were able to use the new methodology to show them the power in this new methodology and to show the participants to build the self-esteem that will make them believe that, of course, there are somebody behind that, but it's all of us, not this person or that person alone. And I think after it can be a difficulty in the beginning, but by the end they will feel more as team leaders and not individual one.
Facilitation techniques identified during the workshop evaluation are incorporated into a simulated group activity on developing shared meaning.
We thought rather than just discuss, which we already did, we would try one other activity from the book. And Rocky was going to lead that for us. And Suhair, oh wonderful. One of the most difficult activities in the book, and that is building a vision.
What is your vision for your community, for your people? Just write one sentence down about that. And that would be your personal vision statement. And then maybe a few of you can share that with the rest of the group. What we will do after that is we will identify what are the commonalities amongst our visions. And then we will consolidate that into a group statement for our shared vision. One single statement that represents all of our visions together.
انسان‌ها باید در اجتماع مفید بوده و خانه سال صفا و صمیمیت برای همه باشند.
Peace in our country. Peace and justice and equality for all.
For all, yes.
Justice and equality.
Sharing, caring and happiness.
I want my community to be educated and strengthen the idea of peace and justice.
Thank you.
Un monde conjugué au féminin.
You just want to translate a world where you conjugate things in a feminine perspective.
Okay. Feminine conjugation.
Promote is promote the right word?
I think we want to go one step beyond promote. The world we want.
We envision.
Vision.
To work.
No, we.
Or we.
We envision.
Okay. We envision
a world.
A world.
Characterize.
A world.
A human rights and peace are respected for all. I think we cover all the rights.
There is a difference when you say equality, what does that stand for? And when you say human rights, that entails something different.
That guarantees the rights of all across gender, race, color, religion, national origin, ability, and class.
Should I this?
Did we miss out anything?
In your first sentence, we envision
the world of
peace, justice.
I'm wondering if we say the language is bothering me. If we envision a peaceful community. Where human rights and dignity are respected for all.
It's a principle that should be respected.
Yes. I understand you. Ah, okay.
Question.
Est-ce que l'exercice, c'est justement
d'avoir une vision commune, donc on peut travailler encore, ou bien cette formulation est une étape pour faire autre chose. Alors, si cette formulation est une étape pour faire d'autres choses, je crois que c'est suffisant et on peut passer aux autres étapes de l'exercice. Mm-hmm. Ou bien, si, c'est,
Amina,
si,
Amina,
si l'objectif...
Amina, attends.
Je crois que c'est clair. Hein?
Maybe the most important thing is the two pages there. We just want to focus on the main ideas. What kind of world we are working for. It is both two parties. One of them is the whole world that we want. But then women in this world. Where are women in this world? And I think the ideas there is very clear.
Sounds like the Middle East book.
Okay, everybody's happy? Okay, I think we should give ourselves.
We envision a peaceful community where human rights, justice, gender equality, peace, and human dignity are respected for all, and where women's rights are guaranteed through education, development, and poverty alleviation, all within a democratic process.
Well, I guess what I will take back from this meeting is the experience, the enriching experience of other people from other cultures, other countries, the struggle that they are in, and the strategies that they have used.
You want the effort of a teamwork, and a teamwork is something that everybody participate, and everybody has a piece of the cake. So if you have a talent or a charisma that be very innovative and encouraging people to bring up that part of themselves out, I think that that is a good leadership, and we have seen the success of it.
The rich experience of implementing the leadership manual and implementing the women's rights in different parts of the world. This rich experiences is going to encourage us more to be sure that the future is better than what we are confronting now.